Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of Health 360. This week on the show, we're telling you why Gen Z is vulnerable and prone to 17 types of cancers and why that report is setting alarm bells ringing. Also on the show, spotlight on perimenopause. Why is there such little conversation around it? We're telling you exactly why screen time is bad. We all know it is, but what is the science behind it? Also on the show, if you're using your mobile phone as an alarm clock, stop doing it. It's causing your body a great amount of stress. I'm Sneha Murdani. This is Health 360. As compared to the population that was born in the 1950s, this particular generation, the younger generation, is particularly prone. And this has got to do with our lifestyles, the obesity rates, our diet. Take a look at this report to get a sense of why this population, this section is vulnerable and what are the experts advising.
The biggest thing that upsets me that from small I have been doing charity to all the special kids and everyone, and till now during my birthdays I go spend time with them, but I cannot have my own child. It was stage 3 starting. Talking to surgeons, they advised me for precautionary measures since it was a metastasis breast cancer to remove my ovary. I'm like feeling a little bit depressed and stressed, thinking why me at this age. They are usually ladies of 40 plus or 45 plus. Like I find myself, I'm the only breast cancer patient from 24 years of age and still I'm going through chemo again.
Prima was just 24 when she was diagnosed with breast cancer. Life has never been the same again for this young patient of cancer.
I used to drive myself and go there, walk of 8 to 10 hours, then return back every now and then. And then I was very independent. And when I got all this, and then my father told me, you should avoid driving now. Everything just came to, like, the life just, it was a green and go green life. Whatever you wanted to do when you started walking and everything. And then everything just came to change yourself.
She is one amongst thousands of young men and women in the younger generation, Gen Z, to be diagnosed with cancer. And this isn't a one-off. There is data and solid research backing the perception that more and more younger Indians are developing cancer. And Gen Z, those born between 1997 and 2012, are at a greater risk of at least 17 types of cancers.
Now we are seeing the early onset of cancers. So that we have Indian data to support that. Some of the cancers, like some of the breast cancers like TNBC, HER positive, aggressive breast cancer, they are more common in younger age group that we see mostly in 30s and 40s. So their behavior is more aggressive. Their outcomes are little less better than compared to the elderly age group.
The study published in the journal, The Lancet Public Health, analyzed data from over 23 million patients who were diagnosed with 34 different types of cancer over 2 decades. The patients ranged in age from 25 to 84, representing multiple generations. Researchers have found that the prevalence of small intestine cancer, kidney cancer, pancreatic cancer was 2 to 3 times higher in those born in 1990 than those born in the year 1955 for both males and females, and for liver cancer in females. Death rates also rose among younger groups for liver cancer, gallbladder cancer, uterine cancer, testicular cancer and colorectal cancer.
The dynamics of change, the kinetics of changes which are happening is very fast. So that a cancer cell which normally might have taken 15 years to become cancerous, it is now being cancerous in 5 years. And what happens that there are, when there are multiple genetic changes running around, the cells, the tumor response, the response to treatment all become unpredictable. It becomes more aggressive, more genetically heterogeneous, and that then, as I mentioned, that they are prone to having more relapse and more treatment failure as compared to somebody who is getting cancer at a late age.
Experts in unison agree that precautions should start early. Modifications to diet and lifestyle could make a substantial impact, particularly when implemented in youth and early adulthood.
So we see a large number of tobacco-related cancers in India, especially affecting the younger population. So that is absolutely preventable by avoiding tobacco. So there is a scope to change. So you need to have a balanced and healthy diet with a good portion of fruits, vegetable, and high fiber and vitamins. So that is called a diet which can protect you from developing cancers. Cancers like breast cancer, endometrial cancer, colorectal cancers, they are all linked to sedentary lifestyles. So some amount of physical activity is definitely recommended.
Caring for our gut's microbiome, the internal mechanism responsible for absorption of vitamins, regulation of the immune system, and assistance with food digestion is essential. Lifestyle modifications can mitigate the risk. Experts also recommend avoiding tobacco use, applying sunscreen to protect against harmful UV rays, and staying up to date on cancer screenings and vaccinations. 40 to 50% of cancers are preventable with lifestyle modifications.